kita pertemuan harus cerita Miss. Ternyata semakin ke sini Miss melihatnya semakin bagus. All of you are better. Okay, so for Ayu, please keep Jill and don't forget to pray based on your religion. Just believe. If you already submit, surrender all your condition, all your missing moment, all your problem, all you need to tell to your God, everything will be okay. Okay, Ayu, don't cry and keep Jill. So guys, tonight we will have a discussion the egg model about scanning its page 81. But before we discuss our topic tonight, I want to invite you to look at our, bisa dilihat PPT-nya semua?
Yes, Miss.
Oh?
Bisa, Miss. Oke.
Okay. So, here, Miss sudah koleksi semua tugasnya. Nah, untuk punya Widyawati, thank you so much. Your assignment is perfect. I don't know. That's your job or your friend's job or others' job. I don't know. But I saw buat Mbak Widyawati tugasnya tidak ada kesalahan yang saya temukan satupun, sempurna. Dan Miss nggak ada nemukan yang ya. Semoga untuk tugas-tugas yang selanjutnya lebih baik lagi. Nah, kebetulan Miss nggak buat PPT punya Mbak Widyawati, but I will share her assignment in our group later. So here, the pertama, let's see, Ayu, this is your homework. I invite you to read it. Come on.
This is about last week's story after the college. Before we back to our home, we visit the hall of We visited the hall of main of Taipei main station. We all together go to the hall. Suddenly our friend Vidya asked certainly about go to Metropolitan Park, because just Anjas who knows that place. So Dia asked to hit the address of Metropolitan Park. The condition not good time so far anyway, and because we must go home, so keep fighting with Dia, maybe at another time we can go to another place for quality time, our friendship. Subject here, our friend Vidya asked certainly about go to Metropolitan Park. Direct object, we visited the hall of Taipei main station. Indirect object, Vidya asked to him the address of Metropolitan Park.
Thank you, Widya. So let's discuss Widya's homework tonight. Come on. So guys, did you still remember what is subject, what is verb, what is object?
Widya, Miss.
Oh, sorry. Ayu.
Yeah, Miss.
I'm remembering her because she doesn't come tonight. She's in her boss party tonight. Okay, yes. Okay, come on guys. Look at Ayu's homework, Ayu's assignment. The first sentence. This is about last week's story after the college before we back to our home. So, Can you identify which one is the subject here? This is about last week story. This is about last week's story. After the college, before we back to our home. Coba Pak Ahmad, Chandra, Hanik, Mbak Hana. Oke, ayo. I'm asking your response. You can type here. You can type
so,
here.
We visited the hall of the payment station. Di situ we subject. Visited verb. Dua. Dan objeknya type payment station.
Okay, so di sini we visited the hall of Taipei Main Station. We as a subject, visited as a verb, the hall.
The hall
as a object.
Object.
Visited as a
station itu.
Wait. Hello, can you listen your my voice? So Miss sebelumnya ada Miss mau bilangin, jadi nanti malam Miss akan upload ini YouTube-nya, mungkin hanya suaranya Miss yang ada, nggak apa-apa ya? Sorry guys, just for this moment, but for another time, it will not happen again. Okay, let's go on. So, Hannah, we is subject, we visited as a verb, TMS, object, yes miss, okay miss. Oh, I see. Yeah, so here, we as a subject, visited as a verb, the whole of Taipei Main Station as a object. So here, there is no direct object and indirect object, right? Okay, and the next sentence, when we work together, go to the hall. When we. So here, so guys, mistakankan, kalau kita ingin menjelaskan, kalau kita ingin menjelaskan kejadian-kejadian yang sudah lewat, yang sudah tidak terjadi sekarang lagi, yang enggak ada hubungannya dengan sekarang lagi, kita menggunakan tenses past tense. Do you know what is past tense? Yes. Can you describe what is past tense? Bisa aja. Masa lampau. Menjelaskan kejadian yang sudah berlalu. And then And then keterangan lampau. What do you know about past tense? So how about the formula of past tense? Menggunakan kata kerja bentuk kedua, yes. And then, okay, so past tense, it is a tense if you want to explain, if you want to describe your past event. Your past event, it means your event doesn't have relationship with this time. Okay, jadi jika kita ingin menjelaskan kejadian-kejadian yang sudah lalu, yang sudah lampau, yang sudah lewat, yang tidak ada hubungannya dengan sekarang, kita menggunakan tenses past tense. Okay, so here, ini kan Ayu. This is about last week's story. It means already sudah berlalu, right? And this story doesn't have relation with this time. Jadi nggak ada lagi hubungannya dengan sekarang. So, if you want to explain your here, if you want to explain your story, all the verb you will use in past tense. For example, let's see. Before we back to our home, we back to our home. Is it correct? Hello, guys. Correct. Before we back to our home. That's correct. So, mana di sini subjeknya? Mana di sini verbnya? Before. So we just see without before, just we back to our home. Which one is the subject here? We as a subject and the verb. To our home as an object. No, to our home, that's adverb. Itu keterangan, keterangan kemana? That's not object. Remember, to our home, kemana? Kesini. Did you still remember? Adverb is if you want to answer how, what, or when. So here, Ayu, is better if you make before we return to our home. Before we return to our home, we visited the whole of Taipei Main Station. That's correct. And then, let's see, when we work together, when we work here, is it correct? It should be verb 2, right? Hello, guys? Hello, Mbak Hana, are you there? Kalau misalnya nanya, dijawab. Yes. Not world cut, world. Iya.
suruh kasih rekamannya dulu yang kayak gitu. Jadi susah susah.
So when we work together, go to the hall. We when we work together, go to the hall. Yang mana subjeknya di sini kan? We as a subject, work as a predicate, together as a verb. So and then go to the hall. Mana subjeknya? Di sini mana lagi subjeknya? Go to the hall. There is no subject, right? Go, that is verb. Yes, we. So, we need to add, kita harus menambahkan we. We go to the hall, right? Yes. And then, suddenly, our friend Widya asked certainly about go to Metropolitan Park. Suddenly, our friend Widya asked is if it should be verb 2, right? Yes, asked about go. So here about go to Metropolitan, about going to Metropolitan or Metropolitan Park. Okay, so because just unjust, who knows that place? So Widya asked plus verb 2, asked to him the address of Metropolitan Park. So remember, you should use the second verb when you are telling your past event, but the condition not good. So mana verbnya di sini? Which one is the verb? The condition is a subject. Good, it is adjective. So which one is the verb here? But the condition is not good. Yes. What's up? Verbnya is. Verbnya is. That's why Miss bilang the condition is not good. Kalau kamu buat cuman the condition not good, there's no verb here. So you should add is. I'm so far anyway, and because we must go home. Okay, so keep fighting, Nidia. Maybe at another time we can go to another place for quality time or frenzy. So let's see here. Subject is our friend Widya are certainly about go to. Nah, so remember, subject is noun. Noun. It's between I, you, she, he, it, we, they, you untuk singular, you untuk plural. Okay? So, look at direct object. We visited the hall of Taipei Main Station. Okay. Jadi kalau di dalam satu kalimat itu tidak ada beda direct object, beda lagi di kalimat yang lain indirect object. Remember, kalau dia tidak ada direct object, berarti nggak ada indirect objectnya. Kalau ada indirect objectnya, berarti ada direct objectnya. Kalau di dalam hanya satu kalimat dia we visited the hall of Taipei Main Station, we as a subject, visited as a verb, the whole of Taipei Main Station just object, not direct object, not indirect object. Do you get it? Did you still remember? Look at this example. I give him a book. So, which one is here? Direct object and indirect object. I as a, of course, I as a subject, give as a verb, him Is it direct or indirect? A book, is it direct or indirect? Which one? Come on, did you still remember our lesson last week? He, indirect object, and a book is direct object, right? Nah, yeah. So, how about this? I love him. So here, is there any direct object or indirect object? So objeknya him di sini, objeknya him. Makanya Miss bilang tadi. Okay, coba kita ulang sekali lagi ya. I give him a book. I as a subject here, give as a verb. Him here as indirect object, a book as a direct object. Apa yang dikasih? Apa yang dikasih? A book, right? It is direct. Sama siapa dikasih? Sama dia. Itu baru indirect. Nah, kalimat yang kedua, I love him. I as a subject, love as a predicate, him as an object, no direct object, no indirect object. Jadi kalau di dalam satu kalimat itu, kalau ada dia direct object, berarti ada indirect object. Kalau ada indirect object. Oh, there's earthquake. Wait. Di lantai 5, gempanya kuat kali, jadi kita nggak terasa ya gempanya. Iya, jadi gempa barusan kuat kali, jadi kita baru keluar, makanya agak berisik. Iya, coba Miss cek bentar ya, sebenarnya ada berapa sekolah sih itu? Kok alarmku nggak bunyi ya? Harusnya bunyi. Tapi lebih kencang ini harusnya. Peringatan tsunami, weh. Iya, aku merinding. Ini orangnya lagi ngomong.
Potensi tsunami ada.
Iya. Di mana, Mbak? Tsunaminya, Mbak? Kerasa, Miss, di Kaohsiung.
Hah? Dekat enggak? Kaohsiung ke kita 2 jam. Tapi mereka lebih dekat pantai daripada kita. Di sini enggak ada pantai. Enggak di dekat kita, enggak di sini ada lagi. Satu kota lagi, baru pantai.
Berapa dari itu?
Santri
maksa lagi.
Dia enggak lari ke sana.
Karena aku pikir keluar mau ke mana?
Iya kan? Aku udah jentuh, aku bawa lo tasku kan. Mana lapangan pikirku? Karena aku ingat profesorku bilang kalau gempa di bawah meja, kalau enggak lari ke lapangan. Masalahnya semua di kamu. Aku mau milih
sendiri. Aku tinggal di sini.
Tadi aku sebenarnya mau masuk ke sini, Bang. Keluar, kau bilang.
Dindungnya, ush, dindungnya saya juga gempa. sumpah,
juga.
cek apa kalian?
Baru aja.
Baru aja.
Di Palembang.
Oh, gila, weh.
Berapa sekali ada ini? Ada kali lima ini, deh. Ada kali lima ini. Jadi kalian yang dapat ini.
Merinding, gitu. Mereka dapat berita apa ya? Ya, aku pintar dulu. Coba tanya, abang itu ada gak gempa?
Ada gempa, bang. Halo?
Di pagar alam. Pagar alam ya, mbak?
Ada gempa, bang. Baru, bang. Aduh. Ada gempa.
5,4 barusan di sini. Di sini, di sini.
Kemarin 5,2 loh.
Kan lebih kuat ini, kan?
Ada. Di Palembang ya, berarti. Ngeri
kalau bang. Iya ini di Palembang.
Yang kelima lagi pikirku mau ngecek ke mana aku. Biasanya kan ada sih.
Itu di Taiwan ya mbak. Itu di Taiwan ya mbak.
Yang ngambil-ngambil itu.
Masih ada susulan, weh. Masih ada susulan. Harap dicatat. Masih ada susulan.
Ini
yang kuat.
Berteman namanya. Itu. Oh iya, aku juga dia apa ini? 4,6.
Iya, aku juga dia lebih
sempat kita ini. Pertama kali gempa itu.
Iya. Itu di mana sih, Mbak? Yang sekarang itu?
Apa?
Itu Bang Ben. Pikir kayak itu kalau udah di lantai 5 kalau enggak.
Mi sudah dapat ini. Mi sudah dapat ini yang di Taiwan 4,6 tapi kan. Alarm dari itu. Emergency alarm. Halo. Ya, Mbak. Itu dari apa di aplikasi handphone emergency alarm
enggak dari kartunya langsung yang mau orang ini
tapi di sini kuat kali. Di Kaohsiung juga Chandra katanya kerasa, Miss, di Kaohsiung katanya.
Ini enggak kerasa lagi sih. Kebetaran.
Serius, tenang dulu kali ini kita bersama.
Aduh. Bentar mau ke gua kali nak pergi lantai 5 gempa.
Aku udah 2 kali datang ke sini bisa belum gempa.
Ini di mana ya?
Di
kedalaman 6,6 km 4,6 km Ciai.
Di Ciai ya?
Ciai County.
Oh,
di sini di dekat sini.
Di Ciai itu Mbak, dekat-dekat pantasan kuat kali dekat kami rupanya Mbak.
Iya, Mbak. Kemarin di Milan.
Ya,
Ciai County.
Tadi kami, maaf ya mbak, makanya bising. Jadi kami itu tadi tiba-tiba lari.
Si bang Sido.
Iya mbak.
Banyak nih uang Sido, pencitraan.
Apa?
Baru lupa ya?
Jadi, ayo kita lanjutkan. Let's. Sampai mana tadi mbak? Lupa saya udah. Udah takut.
Kenapa kita takut dengan gempa?
Direct and indirect.
Bangunan yang menimpa badanmu. Kalau bangunan ini kayak karet, gak masalah.